This is the second day of a really spectacular conference. Those who are not here, I'm sorry you're missing out on the really wonderful dialogue. As we have been truly, myself, have just been absolutely fascinated by some of the dialogue that has been going on, the discussions, talking about the diaspora and the psych mental health needs and well-being and well-behaviors or behavioral needs of across the diaspora. I'm very proud to be ANA's representative as one of the sponsors of this this fellowship program. They're doing absolutely remarkable things, and to see it grow, obviously they're celebrating the 45th anniversary of the existence of this program, and to see where it is has grown from the beginning to where it is today is just absolutely fantastic. One of my main visions for moving ANA forward, one is to increase the diversity of the nursing workforce. And when we had that discussion last night, members of the audience, chimed in that this goes right along with their objectives as well, especially since, not only are we looking at African-American representation, but Native American, Hispanic, and other minorities as well. And one of the things that I want to do is to increase ANA's presence and working relationships with minority nursing organizations. So my task over the next, 14 months of my presidency is to bridge that gap and to give them whatever resources that they need and that ANA would need in order to move forward to make that connection.